She's really good. Yeah. Yeah. See, don't worry about it. What I'm trying to do is keep you close. Makes sense what you're
saying.
It sounds
like
the same.
Maybe
you can
hear it.
I just came to the she was so
yeah.
Yeah, It has that yellow, it has yellow in it. You'd love it. It's a really, I've just discovered it a couple of years ago.
Do they call it buff sometimes?
Yes, I know it is unbleached titanium. I don't like the titanium white, but I like this.
Actually, I never knew they bleached it to begin with.
I think it's coming for a break.
A little break?
And can you talk about the one?
I think you guys are going to need a break. See, for me, if he could pose another 12 hours, I still wouldn't get down. Yeah. There'd be no way into it.
He looks like he did.
But that's just how it is.
Is there any stage of the painting that you find like more challenging than the other, or are they all treated?
I think it's challenging from start to finish. But a really critical thing is making a start, good start. That's, if anything, I like to in instructing and instructing myself is show how to make good starts, because that makes good completions much more likely.
Oh, good.
So here's a little thing to keep in mind when you're doing textiles, is that each and every fold is kind of a cylindrical shape, like a cylinder. And so the main thing to keep in mind is just remembering which edges to soften and which ones to recharge. And in an electric light like this, there's going to be the cast shadow edge is going to be sharp. Hold still. It's safe, but even this little tiny fold, the cast shadow edge is going to be sharp, but the form shadow is soft. Even little tiny things like that, but those are the principles that add up. And so I can't get every wrinkle and fold right. I just try to get the principle and the pattern of it. And it's the same thing when you're, you know, painting ocean waves. You can't get them, but you recognize repetitive patterns. So if I can just accomplish that, you know, basically, essentially getting the right edges soft and keeping the, you know, the cast shadows sharp, which would be different in a, let's say, an overcast light or a north light. But there are, you know, just repeated patterns that you need to see. Yeah, I think it's really impossible to get it exactly in detail. You just get recognizable patterns that are convincing. And say, for example, doing the sleeve, what matters is that the light is brightest where it's most perpendicular to the things it's striking. So that would be the center of his arm, his sleeve. Because it sort of rolls around and slightly darkens toward the edges. So having said that, I kind of have to do it. But it's a kind of thing that you can you know, approximate relatively quickly. So a thing like that, and this sleeve is going to, you know, get brighter as it rolls toward the light. So this even this little tiny edge, it's worth it to, you know, make the top half of it soft and the bottom half of it sharp. And you just go through, and even if you don't get all of them that way, you get the majority of them, and it's going to start to be convincing.
Do you always paint with the rubber gloves?
I really do. Health, you know, without your health you can't do much. So, your skin can absorb solvent if it's exposed to it long enough. I haven't really got these edges quite the way I want. It's kind of abbreviate. It'll just take a long time to really get it. But that, you know, just kind of rolling it with a blender. And then come back in with some black colors. You know, places where the form rolls away from the light, so it's just dark in there. So pure black out of the tube, like, you know, say in a crevice like this under the arm. You want some, you know. Some pure black places. And if they're just little tiny spots.
Thank you.
starting to think you'd suffer enough. Yeah. And this came, you know, it has come to an end at some point. Oh, the tie.
Did you not do the tie yet?
He's just on the chair.
That's kind of cool. I know, it's a prominent up front thing. It hardly knows this. Their fingers are pretty possibly doing the same thing. You know, Sergeant did really get fingers really beautifully. But you notice he never tried something like this. very seldom. It would.
Wait a minute.
John Singer, Sergeant.
He didn't do much of that?
No.
Really?
He would consolidate it wherever possible, put two fingers together, or four, or three.
Oh, yeah.
He was no dummy. We put a hand like that and everything. Full day. And that's what the model is not capable of doing.
Not
quite all of it. No, it's just what I'm saying. Well, for sure, I mean, I like detailed pictures. Doesn't mean you're, sometimes they're not as good as, so.
Yeah.
Just a friend.
All right, so we'll take a break and then I'm next. I locked the door so no one could leave.
Well, I think we should, free yourself from, extricate yourself from the situation you can.
Looks like my son.
Yes.
He's going to a drawing.
What's that?
He's going to a bed drawing.
Oh, good. I'm going to get a picture of that. The bandage here. So. Myself. The fingerprint doesn't work too well.
All right, so we'll start the bidding at
$11. $12.
Oh, sorry.
That's it.
to match the direction of it. We use a charcoal.
Oh, I would have loved to.
Sharpen like this. And with a holder. And so it's about this long. And I'll do that and just kind of learn it in my arm, my muscle memory for like a second. And then go to the drawing and repeat that direction. And then the top of the upper arm. So move over like that and put your whole body in the curve. And so drawing kind of life size or slightly under life size. And I think that gets it into your consciousness sphere, to your hand and your body. Your brain and your hand are working together as one. And I think it reinforces learning, reinforces memory. Because you're trying to learn, you're just trying to remember from in several seconds from here to your pain. And you get it into your body and mind together. And you go all over the entire figure that way. And so, like, look at the slope, you know, the shoulders, one higher, one lower. And so you get that, you grow your drawing, apply that slope. And you do this throughout the course of the drawing. I think drawing in charcoal, things that are close to life size, or maybe three quarters life size, it's just advantageous and easier. And you get it into your consciousness so deeply that you can draw any size. You can draw larger than life, smaller. I think anything larger.
Excellent advice. That's
sweet. So that's really the only thing I was going to try to describe. I think you can follow and talk about just without even seeing it.
Yeah.
Now, I know sometimes when you tend to do the outside of it.
Yeah, that's, you know, there's no right or wrong, whatever works. Some artists work from the center and work their way out. However you get there is fine.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.